بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome you all to our lesson number 25 in the book Alumdah في الفقه for the Imam أبو محمد عبد الله ابن أحمد ابن محمد ابن قدامة المقدسي who died 620 after Hijra rahimahullah ta'ala. We are still going over the same book and we have reached the book of Bay', the book of selling, and today inshallah ta'ala we'll get into a new chapter, and this is the chapter of Riba, usury. So the author said rahimahullah ta'ala, Babur Riba, and the riba is usury, and the riba linguistically speaking is az-ziyada, the increase. So legitimately speaking, it is ziyadatun makhsusa, a specific increase, meaning in specific items. So the riba is proven to be haram, forbidden in the Quran, the Sunnah, and the ijma' of the consensus. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وَحَرَّمَ الرِّبَى, Allah made riba forbidden. And from the Sunnah we have so many ahadith like the hadith of السبع المبقات, the seven destroyer, like in Bukhari and Muslim, when he said صلى الله عليه وسلم اجتنبوا السبع المبقات, avoid the seven destroyers, and amongst them he mentioned الرِّبَى صلى الله عليه وسلم. So the author here رحمه الله تعالى started by saying Babur Riba, and he started with the famous hadith where the issue of Riba orbits around this specific hadith, the hadith of Ubad ibn Samit in Bukhari in Muslim, where the Prophet peace be upon him said الذهبُ بالذهبِ والفضةُ بالفضة والبرُّ بالبرِّ والشعيرُ بالشعيرِ والتمرُ بالتمرِ والملحُ بالملحِ مثلًا بمثل سواءً بسواء فإذا اختلفت هذه الأصناف فبيعوا كيف شئتم يدا بيد فمن زاد أو ازداد فقد أربى. So he said gold for gold, silver for silver, wheat for wheat, barley for barley, dates for dates, salt for salt, like for like, equal for equal, and if the types are different then you may sell any way you wish, as long as it is hand to hand. Whomever increased or asked for increase, he had committed riba, usury. So this hadith is Umdah, is the hadith where the issue of riba orbits around. And this hadith sallallahu alayhi wasallam mentioned six types of item in which they are classified as riba item, meaning that there are specific rules that we need to maintain in order to exchange gold for gold, or silver for silver, or dates for dates, and so on. So once those rules are met, then it is fine to sell gold for gold, or silver for silver, and so on. So the ulama went into opinions, is the usury items only limited to those six items mentioned here, or can we measure other items based on those six items? So the majority of the scholars, they did not limit the riba items to those six specific ones mentioned here in this hadith, and they say if we can know what the reason behind classifying each one of those items as a riba item, then if that reason is available in a different item, then we can measure it upon those six mentioned here. And the hadith here classified those six items into two categories. The first category is al-dhahab wal-fidda, the gold and silver. This is one category. The other one is the four remaining items, which are the barley, the wheat, the dates, and the salt. So if you look into gold and silver, there is a reason for them to be of the same category. Similarly, the case for the remaining four items, it's called al-illa. What is the illa? The reason for classifying those items as riba items. So, just to summarize the concept of classifying the items as riba and what are the reasons for classifying them for riba, before getting into the statement of the author, just to simplify the concept of when things become riba items, or when things, or when a deal becomes a riba deal in this regard. So, according to the madhab here, like Al-Buhuti mentioned, when looking into the reason behind the gold and silver being riba items and the remaining four items being also as a riba items, is that the gold and silver both are weight items which are put into weight. They are weighed. And the reason behind the remaining four items, the barley, the wheat, the dates, and the salt, is that all of them are measured, meaning that they are put into measurement like the kail, like mud and sa' and so on. So if any item which is weighed, like in the case of gold and silver, they say we can measure it to gold and silver and we deal with it as if it is a riba item. And any item which is measured, put into kail, the Arabic word is kail, it is measured in sa' and mud and so on. So also, we can measure it to the four items mentioned here. So this is the madhab for the reason behind those four items being a riba item. Some other scholars, some other madhab, went into different opinions pertaining this issue. But this is what the madhab is. And the author here went into another narration in the madhab, which is a very famous narration, but the most popular is the one I've mentioned to you, said by the Buhuti, rahimahullah ta'ala. And the one said here by Ibn Qudama is also adopted by Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala. So here we need to be aware of something. When you have items of the same reason, so in the case of al-dhahab, بالذهب, Ibn Qudama went into opinion that the reason is not weight, like the famous opinion in the madhab, but rather الثمانية. الثمانية meaning that it is used as a price to pay with in buying items. So, like the Shafi'i and the Malik, and the Imam Malik, they went into this opinion that gold and silver are dealt with as prices, meaning like currencies you paid for goods that you buy. So anything used in this regard, like today's currencies, beside gold and silver, they are deemed to be as price items. And the reason behind them being riba item in this case is because they are used as a price to buy things with. So this is the case with al-dhahab, the gold and the silver, and the reason behind them being as riba items, usury items. And if you look also into the fidda, other four items, the barley, the wheat, dates, and salt, they say that the opinion is that because they are put into kale, measured, that's why they are classified as riba items. And therefore, anything beside those four items which are measured, they are deemed to be riba items. So, like rice, like any seeds that can be used, also can be classified as riba items. So, there is a principle here when it comes to dealing with those items. If the item, the two items share the same reason, therefore you must maintain hand to hand in your deal. For instance, if two items share the same reason, like in the case of gold and silver, share the same reason, which is الثمانية, their price. They're used as a price to buy items with. So gold is a different type than silver, but both say share the same reason. If both items share the same reason, in this case, when dealing with them in buying and selling, they must be hand to hand. If they're not hand to hand, then this is a haram deal. So this is a must condition in order for this deal to become permissible. For instance, in the second category of items, the four items, if you're going to exchange dates for wheat, notice the four items, they share the same reason, the same illah, which is all are makil, they are put into measure or dealt with in measurement, mud or sa'. So since they have the same illah, the same reason, they must be hand to hand. So always keep in mind, if you deal with two items that they share the same illah, the same reason for being a riba item, then they must be hand to hand. If the two exchange items are exactly the same, for instance, gold for gold or wheat for wheat, here you need to maintain two things. It must be hand to hand and it must be the same. مثلا بمثل ويدا بيد. So for instance, I have one saw of wheat and I want to exchange it for two saw of wheat. Notice one for two. Are they the same? No. Then this is a haram deal. Why it's haram a deal? Because it's the same reason, same illah, and same type. Same reason, same type items, you need to maintain hand to hand, and the quantity must be exactly the same. Similarly, the case exchanging gold for gold, silver for silver, salt for salt, barley for barley. It must be hand to hand, and مثلًا بمثل, exactly the same in their measurement. In the case of silver and gold, must be the same weight. In the case of the remaining four items, it must be the same kale measurement. Notice in this case, if you're exchanging gold for gold, and it's exactly the same, but not hand to hand, then here there is riba and nasi'a. Because we have two types of riba. Riba al-nasi'a wa riba al-fadl. Riba al-nasi'a is to delay one of the items which must be dealt with hand to hand. The items which share the same illah, the same reason, if they are not hand to hand, this is nasi'a. If the items of the same type, wheat for wheat, although they are hand-to-hand, but they were exchanged, one is more than the other, here is called riba al-fadl. So the item of the same type, if one is more than the other, this is called riba al-fadl. The item of the same illah, same reason, if they're not given hand-to-hand, then this is called riba al-nasi'a. So I hope this sums up the issue of the riba issue. Let me just list the concept or the principles of those items. So if you have two riba items, which share, first, number one, two riba items, which share the same reason and the same type, like wheat for wheat, for instance. So it must be the same in quantity, must be hand to hand. Again, two riba items, they share the same reason, they are of the same type, like burr for burr, weight for weight, wheat for wheat, gold for gold. We must maintain two conditions, they must be equal and must be hand to hand. If these two riba items, they share the same illah, the same reason, the same cause for being a riba item, but they are different in type, like gold for silver, they have the same reason. Wheat for dates, they have the same reason, but different types. Here, it must be hand to hand. It must be hand to hand. If these two riba items are different in reason, the reason of the two items is different. Ad-da'illah is different. For instance, you have gold for wheat. Notice, the reason for gold is being a price. The reason for wheat is because it is measured, kale. Therefore, if the reason is different, you can sell in any way you want. You can sell 2 grams of gold for 50 kilos of wheat, even if one item is deferred. Not necessarily has to be hand to hand. So you can sell in any mean that you want in this case. The fourth case, if both items are not riba items, For instance, I have apples. Of course, like apples, some of the fruits, oranges, pomegranate, those goods are not sold by weight or by measure before. They are sold by count. You sell 2 apples, 3 apples, and so on. But they are not put into weight like we do these days. Therefore, we deal with those items like how they were dealt with back then. Because the Prophet, peace be upon him, mentioned in a hadith that the kale is the kale of Ahlul Medina. Wal-wazn is the wazn of Ahl Mecca, the people of Mecca. The weight is the weight, the measurement of weight is the measurement of weight of Mecca, and the measurement of kale is of Medina. And back then, this is how they used to deal with those items. And when it comes to commodities or goods like apples or orange juice or some of the fruits, they were counted one by one. So those items are not classified as riba items in this case. So you can sell them in any way. For instance, I want to exchange apple for orange juice. I can exchange 1 apple for 2 oranges. This is fine. I can exchange 1 apple to be given immediately and the 2 oranges to be delayed until the next day. This is fine to do so. But with the riba items, the case is different, of course. So let us go over the statement of the author here, rahimahullah ta'ala, and see what he has to say about the issue of riba. He started by saying, rahimahullah ta'ala, وَلَا يَجُوزُ بَيْعُ مَطْعُومٍ مَكِيلٍ أَوْ مَوْزُونٍ بِجِنْسِهِ إِلَّا مِثْلًا بِمِثْلٍ. He said, it's not permissible to sell مطعوم. Notice here, for the 4 remaining items, the wheat, the barley, the dates, and salt, the author here mentioned another reason. So it is a combination of two reasons, which are with the 4 remaining items. It must be an edible item, which we can eat, beside being a makil, measured or weighed in this case. So if the item, so the author here, according to him, which is another opinion in the madhab, that for these 4 items also must be edible item that you can eat. If the items, they are measured but you don't eat, in this case, it's not classified as riba item. So according to him, he add this other reason or illa, which is mat'oom, an edible item, plus if it is makil, measured or weighed, of the same type. So notice, you have an item of the same illah and the same type. It must be mithlan bi mithl, equal. Of course, if it is the same item which is equal, then must be also hand to hand. And he said, وَلَا يَجُوزُ بَيْعُ مَكِيلٍ من ذلك بجنسه وزنا. If you have an item which is measured and you have an item which is weighed, you cannot, and both are riba items of the same type, if you have the same item, you cannot exchange the same item measured with the same item weighed. So you cannot say, I will sell two handful of wheat for 1 kilo of wheat. Why is that? Because certainly the quantity will be different in both. So if it is the same type of item, wheat, for wheat, it must be measured. For measured, and must be equal, both items. You cannot make one measured, like kale, and the second one be weight in kilos, for instance. So it must be off. Both of them must be measured. It must be exactly the same. Must be hand to hand. So he said, "ولا يجوز بيع مكيلا من ذلك بجنسه وزنا ولا موزون أو ولا موزون كيلا." The opposite also is not permissible, to have 2 kilos of wheat for 1 measure of wheat. You cannot do that. Or the opposite, 1 measure of wheat for 2 kilos of wheat. You cannot do that. Must be of the same measure, both of them, because of they are of the same type. So you need to be aware when dealing with those riba items or items which are measured upon those riba items, like in the case of rice, sesame, or other seeds, corn, and so on. Whenever we deal with them, we need to look into the type and the illah, the reason for it being a riba item. Again, if it is the same type, both items, and they have the same reason, must be equal, must be hand to hand. وإن اختلف الجنسان جاز بيعه كيف شاء يدا بيد. And if the two types are different, then it is fine to sell it however you wish, as long as it is hand to hand. So if the two types are different, for instance, wheat for rice, wheat for rice, you can sell 1 mud of wheat for 3 mud of rice, or the opposite. But you need to maintain a condition here, which is they must be hand to hand. Why must they be hand to hand? Because they share the same illah, the same reason. Both are measured items. Although they are different, but they share the same reason, illah, they must be hand to hand. Since they are different types, wheat for rice, not necessarily they have to be the same quantity. And he said, وَلَمْ يَجُزْ النَّسَاءُ فِيهِ. النساء meaning to delay, not to be hand to hand. Like I said, both items are different. Wheat for rice, it must be hand to hand. If they are not hand to hand, this is riba nasi'a, meaning that you are delaying one of the items which their illa is the same. They must be given hand to hand. And if you don't deal with them hand to hand, then you have committed the type of riba, which called riba nasa', which is a nasi'a. وَلَا التَّفَرُّقْ قَبْلَ الْقَبْضِ. And you cannot separate. If you're doing a deal with someone and you're sitting together, you cannot, and you want to exchange wheat for rice. You want to exchange wheat for rice. You cannot separate unless you exchange the items hand to hand. If you separate without submitting the item hand to hand, then this is deemed to be riba and nasi'ah. He said, illa fi thamani bil muthamman. He said, except for the price given for a good. Like in the case of dhahab, dhahab is used as a price. The item, al muthamman, which is a sil'ah, the item, can be like sha'ir, barley, or wheat, or rice, or dates. In this case, you can, it's fine if you don't give it hand to hand. So for instance, you want to exchange money, gold, for wheat. So it's fine if you don't give hand to hand. So you can delay the money, for instance, and you can take the dates or wheat. Or you can give the money now, and later on you can get the dates or wheat. So notice both are riba item, but they are different types, different illa, different reason. That's why we can sell in any way we wish. And he said, وَكُلُّ شَيْءٍ جَمَعَهُمَا إِسْمٌ خَاسٌ فَهُمَا جِنْسٌ وَاحِدٌ. So any two things which they share the same name, then they are deemed to be of the same type. For instance, if we look into the dates, we have so many types of dates. We have sukkari, we have khalas, we have ajwa. All those types of dates, they are to be of the same type. They are deemed to be of the same type. So if I'm going to exchange a date which is khalas for a date which is sukkari, both are classified of the same type, although they are a subtype of the main type, which is dates. Here in this case, if both are the same type, what is the condition in dealing with this, in these two types? Again, we need to, because they are the same type, they are the same illa, same reason, it has to be hand to hand and has to be mithlan bi mithl, the same. So although it's called sukkari, it's called khalas, it's called ajwa, but they are classified as one jins, one type. Therefore, if it is the same type, then it is the same illa, the same reason. We need to maintain the two conditions, hand to hand and mithlan bi mithl, equal to equal. Illa an yakuna min aslaini mukhtalifain. فَإِنَّ فُرُوعَ الْأَجْنَاسِ أَجْنَاسِ. Unless if they are of different types, then they are different types in this case. وَإِنْ اتَّفَقَتْ أَسْمَاؤُهَا كَالْأَدِقَّةِ وَالْأَدْهَانِ. Even if their names may share the same part of a name. And he mentioned here, you may call the wheat as grinded wheat, which is flour, or grinded barley, okay, which is a flour made from barley. Notice, although they are called it grinded, both of them, but they are in reality two different items. So that does not make them the same type. Although they are called grinded daqiq al-bur, daqiq al-qamh, or daqiq al-sha'ir, the word daqiq, which is a grinded or flour from wheat, flour from barley. Although the word flour is shared between both of them, but in reality both are different types. So therefore, this makes them as different types. And also he said, well, adhan, oil, like oil taken from corn, or oil taken from sesame. Although we call dahan, a simsim, or dahan, a dhura, the oil from sesame, the oil from corn, we have the term oil used by both of them. That again does not make them of the same type, because we pay attention to the reality of the item. Here we have sesame, and there we have corn. So it's two different types. But again, we need to check whether they have the same illa or not to maintain the conditions of exchanging the riba items. And then he said, وَلَا يَجُوزُ بَيْعُ رَطْبٍ مِنْهَا بِيَابِسٍ مِنْ جِنْسِهِ. If one of the items is moist, the other is dry. For instance, we have raisins. Raisins is a riba item, because it is measured like dates, like salt, like wheat, and so on. So dates I mean, raisins are product of grapes. So you cannot exchange grapes for raisins. Although they come from the same source, which is grapes. Why? Because we cannot maintain the equality in quantity between both raisins and grapes. So at all, we cannot sell raisins or exchange raisins for grapes. Similarly, the case we have rutab, the dates which are moist. We cannot exchange it for dates which are dry, like the sukari or khalas. Why? Because we cannot maintain the equality in both in this case. So if this is the case, it's haram to exchange a moist item with the dry item of the same type, like dates for raisins, or rutab, moist dates for dry dates. We cannot sell them, it is haram. And he said, وَلَا خَالِصِهِ بِمَشُوبِهِ. If one of the items is wheat, and the other item is wheat mixed with different item, like wheat and barley mixed together, we cannot exchange. Why? Because by doing that, we'll not maintain the condition which is mithlan bimithl. They should be the same of the same type, meaning one measure of wheat with one measure of wheat. If you exchange a one measure of wheat with one measure, which is a mix of wheat and barley, for instance, then the quantity of wheat and barley and wheat in the other exchange item are not the same in this case. Therefore, it is haram to exchange the items if they are of a such case. And he said, وَلَا نَيِّئِهِ بِمَطْبُوخِ. You cannot exchange a raw item, riba item, with a cooked riba item of the same type. So you cannot exchange wheat for bread, although they are made from the same thing. Why we cannot do that? Because they are classified as of the same type, but they are not equal in this case. The bread which is cooked, which is made from wheat, it's not the same like the raw wheat, which is the exchange, the other exchange item. So if this, in this case, you cannot exchange a cooked item of the same type with an item of the same type which is raw. And then the author mentions a different type of selling or exchanging of dates in specific. The author said, وَقَدْ نَهَى النَّبِيُّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَنِ الْمُزَابَنَةِ. So the Prophet, peace be upon him, forbid المزابنة, which is like he classified and defined here, وَهُوَ اشْتِرَاءُ التَّمْرِ بِالتَّمْرِ فِي رُؤُوسِ النَّخْلِ. So to exchange dates, which you have in your hand, with dates which are still on the tree, this is not permissible. Why is that? Because you cannot maintain the same measurement. 5 sa' here and 5 sa' which is on the still on the tree, you cannot maintain the same quantity. That's why he said you cannot do such a thing. But he said, وَأَرْخَصَ فِي بَيْعِ الْعَرَايَ. But there was an exception which he allowed, صلى الله عليه وسلم, in doing such a deal, to exchange a dry date with a moist date which is still on the tree. Remember that we said before, we cannot exchange a dry item with a moist item, like raisins and grapes. Both are in hand. We cannot do that. Okay? But there is an exception that we can exchange the rutab, which are the moist dates, while they are on the trees, for dates which is dry that we have in our hand. And this is called al-araya. But this is permissible for the following conditions. He said, فِيمَا دُونَ خَمْسَةِ أَوْسُقْ. Anything which is less than 5 awsuq. Remember, the wasaq is 60 sa' and the sa' is for 2 handful of dates, for instance. So if you scoop with your 2 hands four times of dates. This is called sa'. So one wasaq is 60 sa'. So five wasaq is 300 sa'. So the quantity which is that you are exchanging that was on the tree, for instance, must be less than 60 sa'. And he said, أن تباع بخرصها, that it is sold, exchange, while it is measured. Back then, farmers and those who deal with dates and those who collect the zakah of such items, they have the ability to an extent to assume how much the quantity available in this garden, for instance, of dates. So it is assumed by the farmers who deal with those items, they can speculate the quantity in this case. So it is sold by just speculating the quantity which are over the tree with the dates which is in our hand. And also another condition, that the one who has dry dates and he wants to exchange it for the moist dates which is still on the tree, they must eat it and not wait for it until it becomes dry and then they take it, harvest the dates from the trees. No, they must take it while it is moist, rutab. And of course, it must be hand to hand. This is not mentioned by the Sheikh here, but another condition is it must be hand to hand. The entire quantity exchange, hand to hand, not one item is deferred or part of an item is deferred. Both of them must be fully exchange hand to hand. So this is the issue of al-riba that the Sheikh mentioned here. And then he moves to another chapter, which is Babu Bay al-Usuli wa Thimar, the chapter of selling the assets and the fruits. So in reality, people can sell items like trees on a land, only the trees without the land, or they can sell the fruit which are on trees without selling the tree itself. Here this chapter will talk about dealing with such items. And the author rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned the hadith of the Prophet peace be upon him in Bukhari and Muslim, that he said sallallahu alaihi wasallam, man ba'a nakhlan ba'da an tu'abbar fathamaratuha lilba'i' illa an yashtarit al-mubta'. He said, whomever sells palm dates tree, again, remember, only selling the trees in a land, without selling the land, after it is pollinated, فَثَمَرَتُهَا لِلْبَاعِ, the fruit of that tree is for the one selling. So, if there are trees, if I have few palm date trees, and the trees have dates on them, which can be seen, or not even seen. It is only pollinated. And if this is the case, the product of those trees must be taken by the seller and not the buyer. But if that trees were sold before the date trees being pollinated, then whatever comes from that trees later on goes for the buyer in this case. The statement used by the author here is that the condition is being pollinated. But there is another narration in the madhab that if the talh of the tree is split. And of course, when a tree is pollinated, it's not an observable thing to realize. Pollination can take place without us noticing. But there is something that takes place with this, specifically the palm date trees, that there is split on the like branches of the date tree. Once this splitting happens, this is a sign for pollination. So once this takes place and you see the tree that you are going to buy have reached this level, then whatever comes out from those date trees goes for the seller, the first owner of the trees, but not the buyer. And the hadith goes on and mentions an exception. إِلَّا أَن يَشْتَرِطَ الْمُبْتَعَ, unless it is stipulated by the buyer that we should include in the deal whatever comes from the tree, which is being pollinated already. So if the buyer goes and sees that those date trees are pollinated already, and he places a condition that I will buy the date trees with what is coming out of them, the fruit coming out of them, in this case, it is fine to do so. And he said, وَكَذَلِكَ سَائِرُ الشَّجَرُ. And the same case with the remaining types of trees. So any other tree which have been pollinated beside the date trees, then the same case happens to them. إِذَا كَانَ ثَمَرُهُ بَادِيًا. Also, if the fruit is apparent, you can see the fruit apparent on the date trees, similarly the case to the pollinated trees. Again, if there were fruit on a tree which are apparent, and someone came to buy those trees, if they don't mention a condition, the fruit of those trees goes to the seller, unless it is stipulated by the buyer to include those fruits on the trees, then the deal can be done in a such manner that the buyer can take the date, the trees, and the fruit which are apparent on the trees. وَإِنْ بَاعَ الْأَرْضَ وَفِيهَا زَرْعٌ لَا يُحْصَدْ إِلَّا مَرَّةً فَهُوَ لِلْبَائِعِ مَا لَمْ يَشْتَرِطْهُ الْمُبْتَعِ. And if he sells a land, and on that land there is زرع, plants, which is apparent, لَا يُحْصَدْ إِلَّا مَرَّةً, which is not harvested except one time. So again, somebody goes and buys a land, and there are plants on this land, and this plant which are apparent, which are only harvested one time, like in the case of wheat and barley, they are harvested one time. Then in this case, whatever is apparent on the land and it is harvested one time, it is to be taken by the seller, the first owner of the land. He takes those plants and the product of those plants, unless again it is stipulated by the buyer to take the plants. He includes in his deal that he takes whatever plants are apparent on the land. In this case, it is fine to do so. But if they don't mention such a condition, then whatever is apparent and it is harvested one time, it goes to the seller, the one who sells the land. وَإِنْ كَانْ يُجَزُّ مَرَّةً بَعْدَ أُخْرَى. And if this plant which are on the land are harvested more than one time, like in the case of mint or grass or parsley, for instance, that you cut the top of the tree and you take the mint or the parsley, and later on it grows again in a few days, for instance. Such product, they say, فَالْأُصُولِ لِلْمُشْتَرِي. The root of the plant is for the one who bought it. Whatever is harvested one time goes to the owner, the first owner of the land, who is the seller. So again, if there is like grass or parsley or mint, which is harvested one time after another, that you harvest now, and a few days later it grows back again. So the first harvest goes to the owner of the land, the first owner of the land, the seller. While after doing the deal, the second harvest may go, and whatever is after that goes to the buyer of the land. And then he moves to another chapter, and he said, فَصْلٌ, a chapter, نَهَى رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ عَنْ بَيْعِ الثَّمَرَةِ حَتَّى يَبْدُو صَلَاحُهَا. He said the Prophet, peace be upon him, had forbidden. Now, I mean, in the previous chapter, he talked about selling an asset, which is a land or a tree. Now he talks about selling the fruit on a tree. So he mentioned first the hadith of the Prophet, peace be upon him, in Bukhari and Muslim, that he forbid selling the fruit until the sign of ripeness appears. So you cannot buy, you cannot go to a palm date trees farmer and say to him, I'm going to buy from you the product of those trees if you don't see the fruits or they are not ripe or ready to be ripe. Before that, it's not permissible to sell them at all. So this is the case. We cannot sell the product of trees, the fruits of trees, until signs of ripeness starts to appear. Then we may buy the fruit available on those trees. And he said, وَلَوْ بَاعَ الثَّمَرَةَ بَعْدَ بُدُوِّ صَلَاحِهَا عَلَى التَّرْكِ إِلَى الْجَذَاذِ جَاز. And if the owner of the land sells the fruit of those trees, the product of those trees, which the sign of ripeness had appeared, but to keep them on the tree until the time of harvest, it is fine to do so. So somebody came to a land where there are trees planted in this land, and fruits are in the beginning of ripeness. And he went on and he bought those fruit. And he said, but keep them on the trees until they get ready for harvesting. It is fine to do so. And then he said, فَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهَا جَائِحَةٌ رَجَعَ بِهِ عَلَى الْبَائِعِ. So he went to a land, these same trees, and the fruits are almost ready to be ripe. And he said, he makes a deal with him, and he kept the fruits on the trees until the time of harvest. If for some reason the fruit were inflicted by a blight and were destroyed overnight, for instance, then in this case the buyer have the right to return his money back. So the seller is in this case liable, and not the buyer. So the buyer must get his money back in this case, because it was still in the hand of the seller, and the seller still in charge of the trees, and this is something which is not in hand. So therefore, based on the hadith of the Prophet, that he mentioned the statement as a solution, as a way out for such case. He mentioned, لو بعت من أخيك ثمرا فأصابته جائحة فلا يحل لك أن تأخذ منه شيئا بما تأخذ مال أخيك بغير حق. If you sell to your fellow brother fruits, and this fruit, which are still in your possession as a seller, were inflicted by a blight. So overnight some grasshoppers came and they destroyed the entire fruit. He said, فَلَا يَحِلُّ لَكَ. It is not permissible for you to take anything from it. And he mentioned, بِمَا تَأْخُذُ مَالَ أَخِيكَ بِغَيْرِ حَقٍ. Why would you take the money from your fellow brother with no right? So such a thing does not give you the right to say, you already bought it, all that was not harvested, therefore the money stays with me. No. In this condition, the money must be returned to the buyer. And then he mentions signs for the ripeness of the trees. He said, وَصَلَاحُ ثَمَرِ النَّخْلِ أَن يَحْمَرَّ أَوْ يَصْفَرَّ. He said, the signs of the dates, that they are almost ready for ripeness, is that they change in color. They become reddish or yellowish. So once the dates change to red or yellow, this is the sign for budu with salah, ripeness. If this is the case, it is fine to sell them in this regard. And he mentions also the sign for the inab, the grapes. وَالْعِنَبِ أَنْ يَتَمَوَّهُ. So the sign for the grapes is that it becomes moist, full with water. And the signs of sweetness starts to appear. So this is a sign for the dates that they are ready for ripeness. And if this is the case, you can sell such grapes while they are on the trees to a person. وسائر الثمر أن يبدو فيه النضج ويطيب أكله. The remaining products are trees or fruits. The sign in them is you see that they are getting ripe. Ripeness is a sign for any other fruit other than dates and grapes. Once you see them that they're getting ripe, this is a sign that you can sell them. Also, وَيَطِيبُ أَكْلُهُ and becomes fine to eat it. So these are how we deal with the fruits produced by trees, whether it was dates, grapes, or any other trees. So once you see the sign of ripeness here, you may sell the product of those trees. But if there is no sign of ripeness at that stage, it is haram to sell those items at that stage. طيب, let us stop here, يا إخوة. Inshallah ta'ala, we'll get into the new chapter, باب الخيار, in coming class, inshallah ta'ala. بارك الله فيكم. وجزاكم الله خيرا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته